realize this time you're not suspected of any on or off base violations. This is merely a comprehensive vehicle inspection. If I can see your ID, open your glove compartment, your trunk, and any other concealed areas.
Sir, this time be advised you're not being accused of any on or off base violations. This is a military routine inspection.
You people get up here, have your bags open.
Welcome to Subic Naval Base. Gentlemen, I'm Chief Journalist Jim O'Leary. I'm the Assistant Public Affairs Officer for the Commander of U.S. Naval Forces in the Philippines, Subic Bay. What we're about to see is the largest U.S. naval installation outside of the continental United States. Our primary mission here is to support units of the 7th Fleet, which operates in the Western Pacific region. At any one time, we have about 10 ships in port, including a complement of about 3,600 sailors and Marines. They're undergoing maintenance on their ships or just relaxing on rest and recreation here in one of the best liberty ports in the Pacific, if not in the world.
Smart disco-goers knows there's one best stop after hard day's work. New York Disco employs beautiful, sexy, and trusted employees and accept parties in all locations with no COVID charge, backed up with honest quality service. New York Disco will make your night safe and sound with the good management of Jay Salvador. Go to New York Disco. Convenience everywhere around.
Extra strength. Aspirin Free Medical. With the extra strength of 500 milligrams pure acetaminophen, can be taken by pregnant women and those with heart ailment or asthma. Extra Strength Medical. For headache, fever, and flu.
Hello, darling. Hello, sweetheart. Here is the news about U.S. ship here in Olongapo City and ship arrival of your boyfriend. As of now, in Olongapo City, we have 3 U.S. ships docked inside U.S. Naval Base, Subic Bay, Philippines. One USS Cruiser, one USS Destroyer, and one USNS Merchant Ship with more or less 1,600 U.S. servicemen.
Here in Olongapo City, if there is no U.S. ship, there is no business in Olongapo City, and 100% of the residents of Olongapo City is pro-American, and we love very much American because they are helpful, friendly, and we are for the retention of U.S. naval base in the PI.
Sampaguita Beer Garden, sexy mga agogo dancers, maganda descending mga entertainers at mga waitresses. Sampaguita Beer Garden.
Ako si Rose, 28 years old. Nakatira ako sa Olongapo 5 taon na. Kasama ko anak ko si Karen sa bahay. Kasama ko rin kapatid ko, si Nora. May dalawa siyang anak, si Robert, si Jennifer.
Alis dyan, Jess. Huwag kang maingay.
Ay, titit lang ko.
Sabaw. Sarap yan. Smell ko, di ba? Saan ang kuya mo?
Robert!
Oh, Robert! Robert, ayun na ako! Marami pa akong ginagawa. Huwag ka masyado malikot na ako.
I'm from Masbate. My dad's fisherman, sometimes carpenter. It's a hard job. Nanay ko namatay nung kahuli-hulihan yung pinanganak kapatid kong lalaki. 5 taon na nakaraan. Kain na, kain.
Eat na. Bumito kami ng kanit.
I'm the oldest in my family. I got 5 sisters, 7 brothers. My 3 sisters are married for 3 servicemen. 2 Marine and 1 Air Force. 1 live in Oklahoma. Ang anak ko naman si Karen, siya ngayon ay 10 months. Bala ko sana ipadala ang anak ko sa kapatid ko papuntang stage. Kaya nagbago na lang ako. Kasi bata pa siya eh. Alam ko habang lumalaki yung bata, baka hindi na ako kilalanin. Masakit din para sa akin yun. Siguro naman, kaya ko naman siguro. Sa lukoy ngayon, kumikita man kahit papano.
I'm a C-2 pilot. I'm here on a 2.5-year tour. And my job is to fly the C-2 out to the carrier, to deploy with the carrier if I have to. And basically, that's our squadron's job.
Kamustika.
I found this house through the Navy Housing Service. I kind of fell in love with it as soon as I walked in the front gate. I'd always imagined myself living in a big hacienda-style house. And, you know, big rooms inside and everything like that, where I could sit out on the porch and sip beer or whatever I wanted to do and watch the sunset over the banana trees on the mountaintop.
Mmm. What we got, Shanghai Lumpia? Looks pretty good.
This kind of fits the mental image I had in my brain of, you know, living the good life in the tropics.
How was your day?
I employ a one maid, cook, housekeeper. Meringue. She was recommended to me by the landlord. She's very good. She runs the house, basically. I don't have to worry about anything. Not only does she keep it spick and span, she's an excellent cook. And she's very honest. And I don't have to worry about the security of the house while I'm gone because I know she's here watching out after me. I guess I'm just like the rest of the single guys here. We go out bar hopping on Fridays and Saturdays, maybe in the middle of the week. And generally have a good time, flirt with the girls, down a couple of San Miguel's, that sort of thing.
Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. See you tonight.
Look.
Wow!
Nagtatrabaho sa Rock Lobster bilang dancer. Kami lahat dyan nagtatrabaho. Bali, yung dancer namin 48, bali 15 yung entertainer. Pasok namin alas 4 hanggang alas 12 ng gabi. Ang kita namin isang gabi, 40 pesos. Minsan, may kano pupunta sa bar. Nakita ka, maganda ka, marunong ka sumayaw. Nilalapit siya yung customer, kakausapin ka, bibilang ka ng drinks. Ilang naman ang bali, bali dagdag sa kita namin dun sa drinks kasi medyo mahal ng konti. Minsan, may kakagusto naman sa amin, sasama kami ng bar fine. Kung gusto namin kumita ng pera, nasa amin na yun kung ilang gusto, ilang beses mo sumama ng bar fine.
If you go to a bar and you bar fine a girl there, you couldn't bar fine any other girl there on any other night, even if you wanted to. That's called butterflying when you bar fine two different girls in the same bar. They don't like that at all, and the girls' loyalty to each other is such that they won't even approach you except in friendly conversation if they know that you've already bar-fined one of the girls they work with. They're almost like a sisterhood within the separate bars. I don't see any stigma associated with them, and it's not something I'd write home about necessarily, but You know, I have no problem at all associating with them. You'll find girls out in town whose mothers were bar girls, whose grandmothers were bar girls, and you'll find girls out in town whose fathers fought and died in the Vietnam War. I'm talking about American fathers, and even some whose grandfathers were World War II vets. It's sort of a family business that keeps going.
Po, kami lahat dito, balit 30,000 babae nagtatrabaho sa bar. Ang ibang babae, nagagaling pa sa malayo. Ang iba galing sa probinsya. Ang iba is away. Hindi alam ng pamilya nila, takas lang sila, pero hindi alam nilang babag sa kanila dito kung anong trabaho.
Hello!
Minsan, hindi nila alam. Mga dalaga pa dyan, umpisa dyan, mga 16 to 14, umpisa na magtrabaho ng bar, pero hindi alam ng pamilya nila kung anong trabaho talaga. Nagtatrabaho lang sa bar mga babae dito kung talagang hirap sila sa buhay nila. Kaya napapapunta sila sa lugar na to. Mahirap din para sa aming kalagayan namin, trabaho namin. Kailangan buwan-buwan din kahit paano makapagpadala ka ng pera din sa probinsya kasi kailangan din ng tulong ng pamilya mo sa probinsya. Lalo ngayon kababagyo lang. Wala kahit ano man yun sa amin sa lugar namin. Kahit nakamunting kahoy, puno niyog, wala. Siguro sa isang taon bago man ulit ang niyog dahil kagaya nga sa Bisaya, lahat ng babae, marami nga isa ngayon nanggagaling sa Bisaya. Nangangailangan din ng trabaho. Ngayon, binagsakan nila ngayon puro sa bar. Ngayon, ibang babae naman, nagpapadala silang pera para patulungan pamilya sa pagkain. Talagang hirap ngayon talagang mga magulang sa probinsya.
I'm a bar owner of sorts. I mean, I've got two maids, a chauffeur, a gardener, everything that I could possibly ever want. It's kind of like being one of the Beatles, but not having to sign autographs.
Hey, Bob, you got the next game. You're next.
Basically, the guy goes into the bar. There's drinks, regular price for him if he wishes to buy a young lady a drink. It's an inflated amount to do that. If there is a mutual attraction or a singular attraction, however it may be, the guy can pay the girl's bar fine. Or in other words, he's paying to take her out of the bar for the night. If he falls in love with this girl and decides he wants to take her out of the bar on a permanent basis, he pays what is called a steady bar fine. That can be anywhere between $200 and $300, I suppose, for that. Then he can take it from there, whatever he likes to do. If he wants to get married, go back to the States, whatever, that's entirely up to him. Most of the girls range in age between 17 and their late 20s. But if you were to reach your hand into a bucket and pull out a handful, you'd probably be talking between 17 and 22, 23 years old. It's wonderful. And I can be with women that are much my junior. I'm over here about 10 months out of every year. I like to go back to the States for a couple of months just to go back and touch reality. If you will, it's like Alice in Wonderland and stepping through a looking glass. It's easy to wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning and decide that you want to go out, and it's all there at any time, 24 hours a day. A lot of people ask me if there's a problem, you know, don't I miss talking to my white Anglo-Saxon wife? No, I don't. If I want an intellectual conversation, I can just as easily talk to you about it. And you and I can talk about football or soccer or baseball or whatever. But I don't need a bumpy-fronted girl, white girl, to, you know, carry on an intellectual conversation. Sorry.
Hey, you come here.
Thank you.
lahat ng babae na gusto namang pag-asawa ni ng sailor. Mapag-asawa, makarating sa... talagang gusto nilang guminawa rin ang buhay nila. Make happy by yourself. Looking for good-looking guy. Not all. Hindi lahat ng babae napapakasalan ng kano. Pagdating ng tumanda ka na sa bar, kawawa ka. Trabaho ng bar. Pagdating ng 40 anyos, 50 talagang hindi na po pwede yung mama sa nalang ibabag sa kanila.
Huwag na pumasok kayo dito, kukuha na na makakain tayo sabay-sabay. Gusto mo sa layot? Akin to.
Ako lang, may kulang lang. May yuk na ilit.
Nung isang taon, 10 babae ang rock lobster ay kinasal sa U.S. serviceman.
Saan sa malalim?
Ang iba station dito ng pangasawa nila, iba wala na rito, nasa stage na. Minsan nagpapadala sila sa amin dito ng cards, postcard, pangumusta sa sulat, kung ano nangyayari sa kanila doon. Parang maligaya na lang kami, be happy. Kasi gusto, kagaya ng karating na sila doon, parang ibang pakiramdam ng kapwa nila babae. Parang nagpupursige rin sila na para makapag-asawa rin sila, makarating din sila sa pinunta nila. Tungkol sa akin naman, pangarap ko rin makarating sa ibang lugar. Tungkol naman sa mga Pilipina na bago mag-asawa sa kano, bride school sila sa loob, kagaya ng tuturuan sila mag-speak English, mag-sulat ng right English. You got cooking class, ceramic, aerobic. Yung pinaka-importante sa kanila yung makaintindi ng salitang wika ng Amerikano. Kaya bago ka matapos ang bride school mo, bago ka ikasal sa kano, makapag-aral sa loob. Paano ang gagawin tuturo sa'yo?
Okay, ladies, this is the bride school kitchen. And I'm going to tell you about some of the appliances that you're going to be using being married to American service members or service members. Okay, this is our refrigerator. Okay, the bottom part of it is to keep items cold. The top part, keep items cold and frozen, like your meats and things that you're not ready to cook right away. Secondly, we have the microwave. Okay. Probably not familiar with the microwave because it's kind of relatively new. You just put the food in here, select the temperature or select the time and the temperature and so forth. Lastly, we have the washer and dryer. Some of you might be used to using the hands, washing in the hands. What you do is you take, put your clothes in here, dirty clothes in here. Okay, and then you push it out and it washes. You take it out and you put it in your dryer. Select the amount of time that you want and press start. And after a certain period of time it's dry, take it out, fold it up and it's ready to go. This will help you to make your service like being married to a serviceman.
I really do like the Filipino woman. I think she has a lot of the characteristics that, most American men are looking for. It's kind of, the bar girls, it's true, they're making their livings on their backs. But at the same time, I think one of the reasons they're here is they'd like to marry an American serviceman, go back to the States, escape the poverty of this country, and raise a few kids, you know, kind of like Susie Wong joining the PTA or something like that.
Okay, I am Lynn James. I am the budget counselor and the consumer educator for the Navy Relief Society. I have been invited here today by the Marriage School to give a presentation to you on budgeting and checking account management.
What is a budget? It's a plan, a spending plan. Yes, very good. A roadmap, if you will, through your financial future, how to spend your money, or in our case, how to spend your husband's money.
I wouldn't be at all surprised if I got married before I left the Philippines, because I find these women very charming, and as well as being extremely attractive, and I'm sure you've noticed that. Like I said, they're not as self-centered as American women. They have very traditional values about the home, family, being a devoted wife.
Okay, food, shelter, clothing, and transportation. Those are your needs as a human being. Everything else is a want. Everything else is a want. As in most things, we as women must do the hard job and leave men the easy job. They will go along with trying to live on a budget, but try not to limit them too much. Don't take all of their beer away, just some. Don't take all of their recreation away, just a little bit. Life is supposed to be joyous. Do not have a budget that is so restrictive that there is no joy left in your life.
Pero mababae din sa bahay, hindi rin po pwede pumasok kahit sa mambar kung wala, hindi, kailangan mo rin talaga lisensya. Hindi ka rin basta-basta machichikap ng doktor kung wala kang, wala ka pa lisensya, wala kang ID, wala kang green card, wala kang yellow card. Tungkol, kung nagtrabaho ko talaga sa bar, every set, dalawang linggo, isang basis ka is may rin. Ngayon, kung may diferensya ka, may sakit ka, hindi ka rin papasamahin ng mamasan. Saka, no, kung may sakit ka, kailangan magamot ka muna, marichik ka.
The Sexually Transmitted Diseases Control Program in Olongapo City is a joint undertaking between the city government and the U.S. Naval Base. The U.S. Navy provides us material and financial support, the equipments and the medicines. Medicines are given free of charge, while the government takes care of the staff, the building, and the facilities like light, water. We have 31 employees here. There are 11 medical technologists, 4 nurses, 7 contact tracers. The rest are clerks.
The bird. The bird? Can I have some smear mo?
Wala. 3 weeks.
3 weeks. Anong pangalan?
Lourdes Lamir.
Cup? Last smear. August 25, last smear. Give me to sa manager mo, ha? Tapos ito gamitin.
The entertainers who are working in the business establishments usually report here every 2 weeks for smear examinations. Well, we examine a minimum of 500 patients daily, 500. Then if they are found positive, we send out notices to their respective managers to bring these girls here for treatment. Most commonly encountered sexually transmitted disease here is gonorrhea. We also get a few cases of herpes, sometimes venereal warts, and occasionally also we get non-specific urethritis. All of the service employees in the business establishments in Olongapo undergo a blood examination every 6 months. That is for the test for syphilis and for AIDS. Well, as of this date, there are around 30 cases of positive, HIV positive individuals. Most of them are not working in the clubs anymore. Either they have gone home to the provinces or they have taken other forms of jobs, but no longer in the clubs. A few of them still work in the club, but no longer as entertainers, as waitresses.
Once again, I would like to say good evening to all the guys and girls tonight. USS New Orleans, USS Mount Henry, USS Fresno, USS Ogden, USS Mobile, USS the Spirit. BC 5.
Kaya dito sa bahay, kasama ko, may dalawa ditong buntis. Ang problema ko, gusto nila ipalaglag yung bata. Pero limang buwan na yung bata, nasa tiyan ng kaibigan ko, di ko alam kung anong gagawin ko. Kung susulatan ko pamilya niya, o ipapalaglag namin. Pero ang desisyon ako, tulungan na lang kami, palaki na rin yung bata, dahil limang buwan na yung nasa tiyan ng bata, ng kaibigan ko, wag na namin ipapalaglag. Just keeping the baby.
Ships come here, they stay for a night or two, about a week. So those bar girls who don't have any form of contraception gets pregnant. The first thing that gets into your mind will their mind will be they don't have money, they will have to stop their job, so they resort to abortion. Sometimes the males come in and and support them until they get married. When this time comes, it ends up quite nicely, see? The girls have something to support themselves, the babies have something to support themselves. But if the Americans don't choose that, usually they're not married, they even don't know the names, it's a fly-by-night affair, so where would they follow up the men? If they decide not to keep the baby, they go to illegal abortion, because you know, in the Philippines, abortion is not legalized. So the first problem would be there. Abortions and its complications. Usually abortions done outside are associated with problems of incompleteness or with infection. Then when it's being induced already, they go into the hospital, we do the final treatment. Okay? Mainly the problem with this will be financial. Even if we try to do the best thing for them, they don't have the money. In the gynecological ward, 50% of the cases are secondary to abortions, induced abortions. What they usually do would be catheterization. That means they insert catheter in the cervix to induce the abortion. And if this is not done on a clean setting, you induce infection. The risks are really very high. You stimulate the baby's death in about 90 to 100% of cases.
We will return to...
We'll be right back.
you're pregnant, you can't work in the bar. You can only work for a few months until your stomach doesn't show. When it shows, you're out of the bar. If they decide to carry the baby to term, we usually let them go through normal labor. If they are able to bring the baby out, there's no problem. You see, genetically, the babies of Americans would be bigger. In half of these cases, because of the bigger babies, they are not able to undergo normal deliveries. So we do abdominal deliveries to carry out, to bring out the baby. And usually our problems will be securing the medications they would need for the operation. You see, an operation of a cesarean section would cost about, the medications would be about anywhere about 1,000 pesos. That would be $50. And even with that much, they don't have the money. Usually the girls can either keep the babies from for themselves, that's why they rent an apartment, they let their children stay with them and support them, or get the baby out to their relatives, to their father or mother, in other place where they work, but still support the babies. Secondly, they either have them adopted, whether legally or illegally. And thirdly, they apply the baby for a support by charitable institutions.
Tungkol naman sa anak ko kay Karen, siya ngayon ay 10 buwan na. Ang tatay niya ay sailor. Nagkahiwalay kami ng ama ni Karen. 4 na buwan pa lang sa tiyan ko ang dinadala ko. Nagkahiwalay kami kasi sobrang asto niya, hindi ko kaya ang ugali niya. Kasi pasensyahan kami. Alam ko malaking trouble ko nagawa ko sa kanya. Kasi pasensyahan na lang kami. Yun ang naman gagawa ko para sa kanya, para marami din kasi ginawa siya rito ang kalukuhan. Ang tungkol sa tatay niya, hindi na siguro kayo magkakabalikan kailanman. Alam ko nang gusto niya pa rin kunin dito ang bata, pero wala siyang karapatan. Dahil kahit ni Singko man, wala siya ibinigay niya hanggat binuntis ko yan, hanggat ipinanganak ko yan. Ni Singko, wala siya ibinigay sa akin. Bilang ina, masaya ako para sa kanya pag uwi ko ito, pagod ako sa trabaho. May kalaro ako. Lahat ng problema ko, makita ko siya. Nawawala lahat ang pagod ko. Kahit anong pagod ko, makita ko lang siya, maligaya na ako. Kaya ako napabinyagan si Karen, dahil gusto ko siya maging Kristiyano. Masaya ako dahil sa pagkakaanak ko rin kay Karen. Dahil lahat ng bisyo ko, nawala sa buhay ko. Sa ngayon, pinag-iipunan ko siya, may konti akong pera para sa kanya. Gusto ko nga, binabala ko ngayon, magkapagtayo man ng kahit maliit na tindahan o maliit na restaurant, para makapiling ko siya, para kalimutan ko muna magtrabaho ng bar. Makapag-asawa man ako ng sailor o whatever, make me happy, that's okay. Makapag-asawa man ako, gusto ko, mahalin din yung anak ko, o paano ang treat ko sa bata, ganun treat sa anak ko, that's fine. Ayoko rin siyang lumaki, nakaparis namin, ang lumaki siya nagtrabaho ng bar, hindi mangyayari yun. Dahil pag susumikapan ko siya, para maiba naman takbo ng buhay niya, it's different, no, it's not gonna happen. Same my niece, Robert and Jennifer. Di ko siya, di kagaya ng ibang bata dyan, kakalat-kalat sa daan, kasi walang tatay. Siguro hindi naman siguro mangyari sa anak ko, kasi maganda pangarap ko para sa anak ko. Malayo mangyari yan sa iniisip na ibang tao dyan. malayong iniisip ko para sa anak ko. Gusto kong maging maayos ang kinabukasan ng anak ko.
Kaya naman mga Mingo at Inang, nakaanto pa kayong tumulong sa mga magulang ng batik ito sa kanilang tungkulin. Sigapan ninyong bubuhay siya ayon sa diwa ng ating relihiyon upang ang buhay ng Diyos na pakakalog sa kanya ay lumagos sa tuwing at huwag mapawi sa kasalanan. At lahat kayo mga ninong inang, Karen, ikaw ay binibinyagan ko sa ngalan ng Ama, ikaw ay binibinyagan ko sa ngalan ng Ama, ng Anak, at ng Espiritu Santo.
Monday, a dead man's last words, a mystery woman, and a doctor with a prescription for murder. On the Agatha Christie Hour, why didn't they ask Evans? Now stay tuned for Scott of the Antarctic, next on A&E.